Hey everybody, welcome back to my Final Cut Pro 10 tutorial. In this video, I'm going to go over how to organize, label, and tag all your media, so it's quick and easy to find when you need it. In my last video, I talked about importing files and briefly explained all the settings you can choose. If you'd like to check it out, I've included the link in the description and up top. The stuff you'll learn in this video isn't necessary, but a few minutes spent organizing at this stage will save you hours in later stages. That way, when you're editing, you don't disrupt your flow by trying to find specific clips. If you enjoy this video, please click the like button and subscribe below, and feel free to ask any questions in the comments section. So, let's get started. Over here, in the Libraries pane, you can see that Final Cut Pro has already started to organize some of your files. It separated all your different file types, but there's still some work left to do. First thing I like to do is add some keywords to my clips. In this first clip, I'm riding through a city and using a helmet cam. So I'm going to select this clip, click this keyword button, and type in city. When I hit enter, two things happen. First, a blue line shows up at the top of my clip to indicate that a keyword was applied to this clip, and second, a keyword collection is created in the library pane. If you click on it, only clips with this tag will show up. You can add as many keywords to your clips as you like. I'm also going to add helmet cam keyword to this clip. Another way to create a keyword collection is to right click an event and choose new keyword collection. I'll create one named freeway. Nothing shows up because no clips have been tagged with this keyword. I'm going to select day one event and control click all my freeway riding clips. Now I can just drag them over into my freeway collection. You can add as many or as few keywords as you feel necessary to keep your files organized. I'm going to go ahead and add some keywords to my day two event. You can also add keywords to only a certain part of your clip. For example, in this video, I go around a curve. I'll skim the video to where I'm just about to enter the corner and press the I key on my keyboard to select my in or start point. Now I'll skim to where I come out of the corner and press the O key to select my out or end point. Only part of the clip is selected. Now I can apply a keyword to just the selected part of the clip. I'll click the keyword button and type curve and hit enter. Notice how the blue line on top is only applied to the portion of the clip. Now when I click the curve keyword collection, Final Cut Pro only shows me the part I selected instead of the whole video. Next, let's assign some ratings to the clips. 99% of the time when editing a video, you'll have way more footage than you're going to use. It helps to skim through the footage and pick your favorite parts. I'll skim through my clip and use the I and O keys to select my favorite parts of the clip. I can rate this part of the clip as a favorite by either pressing the F key or clicking the green star button. A green line appears over the portion of the clip that you rated. You can rate more than one part of the same clip. When you rate a clip, or part of a clip as a favorite, it's automatically added to favorites in the Smart Collection. You can unrate a clip by selecting it and clicking this Start button, or by pressing the U key on your keyboard. When you have parts of clips that are unusable, you can also reject them to hide them from view. In my clip here, I adjust the camera with my hand. I know I don't want to use this part, so I'll select it with my I and O keys. To reject this clip, I could click on the red X button or press the Delete key. This won't actually delete this part of the clip, just hide it. And because this part was in the middle of my clip, my video got split into two parts, the part before and the part after the rejected clip. Final Cut Pro Browser defaults to hiding rejected clips. You can change that in the Filter pop-up menu by selecting Show All. The rejected parts will be identified by a red line. But since I decided not to use these parts, I'll get rid of them by selecting the Hide Rejected setting. I'll go through and tag and rate all my clips. After that, I can easily navigate my library and quickly find the clips I need by selecting different collections. You can also set rules in Final Cut Pro and automatically create custom smart collections, but that will require its own video. If that's something you're interested in, drop me a line in the comments and I can make a video for it. Now that all the boring stuff is done, you're ready to make the first edit. I'm going to show you how to do that in my next video. I'll link it in the description and up top when it's posted. Click the subscribe button and turn on notifications so you don't miss it. Once again, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it and come back for the next part of the tutorial.